We just heard a passionate speech, a plea. I want to say something very different, because from times immemorial, when creation began and the prithvi, the earth, as we know, came into being, there have been conflicts of all sorts. For me, as a person, as a woman, and as an artist, it is very important to carry within myself certain values, certain ideals, certain aspirations and convictions. My conviction is somewhere in a different direction. I think this particular conference, everybody is talking about peace, non-violence, friendship, etc., humanity. These are big words. Very big words, very big ideas. I think nothing new. But what may be new or what may be interesting would be to instill some beauty. Some beauty, not only in our lives, but to share it. And this is my work, my lifetime's work. The word Shanti, he began, people have been saying Shanti. You'll be interested to know that in India, in the Indian philosophy, Darshan, we call it, Darshan Shastra. And Darshan is not seeing, but Darshan is the perception, deep perception. Shanti comes right at the end of the whole spectrum of the Navarasa, the nine major moods, sentiments, feelings, emotions, whatever is the translation of the rasa. Actually, rasa is something that imbues life, existence, with meaning. Without rasa, flavor, taste, feeling, there is nothing. It is all like matti. So the Navarasas are very interesting. And for Indian dance, music, painting, sculpture, weaving, rangolis, indeed everything, rasa is the basis. And rasananda, the ananda, the bliss of tasting rasa has been compared to brahmananda. That knowing, the final satori or nirvana or kaivalya, whatever we may call it. So rasananda is something without which there is no life. Our navarasas begin, I told you they end with Shanti, but they begin with Shringar, which is love, beauty. Love equal to beauty, beauty equal to love. We say Satyam Shivam Sundaram. So the whole spectrum, if it begins with love and ends with Shanti, then we can see the whole rainbow arch of all kinds of emotions. There is Raudra, which is fury and anger. There is Veera, which is bravery, nobility, heroism. There is Vibhatsa, which is disdain, indifference, There is Adbhuta, fundamental surprise. There is Bhaya, fear, fearfulness. There is Hasya, mirth and laughter. Like this, unbelievably, only India, we have recognized all the human emotions as being the main ingredients of a well-lived life or simply life. I would like to take up then the first one, Prema, Shirdar. This is a conference on Sufism. For me, the word means nothing and everything. Who is a Sufi is not the question. We are all Sufi. Even a dog can be a Sufi. Why not? Because they give unconditional love. The tree is a Sufi. It gives unconditional shade and fruits. The flower is a Sufi. The honeybee, madhumakhi, is a Sufi. Without tasting its own honey made, created by it, that honey is distributed among others. Here, I would like to quickly bring in my short little time, the name of Jaydev of Orissa, a 12th century poet. I won't call him Sufi poet, I won't call him love poet, simply poet. Because poet is Kavi, as somebody mentioned in the morning session. And Kavi in the Rig Veda means the knower. One who knows, and what is that knowing we know, the five of knowing. So, Jaydev is the Kavi of 12th century Orissa. And with only one poem, the Gita Govinda, Jaydev is still remembered as one of the greatest in the world. For me personally, Gita Govind is my Gita, Bible, Quran, everything. Why? Because from beginning, the first word, Meghe Meghe Ramam Param Paragoshyama Tamalatumayi, from there to the last 24 cantos, it speaks of nothing but love in all its concomitant shades. And all the shades that we experience, if we are aware. So for me, Sufism is also about awareness. And Gita Govinda is the story, the love between Radha and Krishna. And for me again, Radha is the Sufi. Krishna is the lover, but Radha is the real Sufi who teaches Krishna what is love. And Jaydev writes about it. Jaydev imagines it. Jaydev lives it. And Jaydev has given us this great poem, Gita Govind, which I recommend highly for everyone to read. I've also heard so many poets, philosophers being quoted. The crux of the Indian darshan, Indic darshan, is in dance and music lives God. In dance and music lives God. God, godliness, the sacred, the unknowable made knowable, the formless given the form. The one who has no attributes, Nirguna Brahma, Nirakar, made Sakar, Saguna, so that for us it is easy to relate. You can fight. You can fight, you can abuse, you can love, you can worship, you can be a friend. It is that kind of relationship which I think is the real Sufi relationship. And I just wrote a little thing. I don't know, it comes to me, sometimes I forget, sometimes I write it down. This came to me 2-3 years ago, I just remembered it. I don't know, there must have been something wonderful. And I wrote, I am drunk with my existence. Mujhe mere astitva ka nasha ho gaya hai. एंड ये जो नशा है वही तो सूफी सब है, वही तो प्यार की मदीना है। मैं ही साखी हूँ, मैं ही सनम हूँ, मैं ही शराब हूँ। सो द होल बीइंग, द एग्जिस्टेंस, व्हेन इट ओवरफ्लोज विद पेन, लव, अवेयरनेस, फाइनली इट ब्रिंग्स यू टू दैट काइंड ऑफ पीस विच इज नॉट द पीस ऑफ अ क्रोकोडाइल बिफोर ग्रैबिंग द शिकार। It's the kind of a oceanic peace which may have waves and ripples, but deep down it is calm and the calmest. And that is what for me is Sufism. Thank you very much for your time.
Hello. Thank you, Sonal Mansingh ji, wonderful presentation you have made, and also your presentation was very impressive. Thank you very much. I make my own announcement. I am going there tonight.